Your initials are CC.
CCC.
CCC.
Carly Christine Kerrigan, yes.
Got it. And they call you... Oh, you know.
Double D.
Oh, did she just bounce?
Look at...
You can do that on Family Feud? This is the greatest show I've ever had.
It's time to play Family Feud. This is Joey Fatone from Universal Orlando Resort in sunny Florida. And now, here's the star of our show. Give it up for Steve Harvey!
Everybody, welcome to Family Feud. I'm Steve Harvey. We got the Kerrigan family playing against the Salisbury family. All of this for a chance to win a lot of cash and a brand new car. Right there. Right there. So let's get it on. Give me Kimberly. Give me Bryant. Let's play.
Go me.
This lady here. Top six answers on the board, everybody. Name a cowardly way to end a relationship. Kimberly.
Text. Yes.
Okay, yeah.
Come on, text.
Right? Phone call. Kimberly, you control it.
Play!
Yes. Yay! Yes, they're gonna play. Triple C?
Triple C. Carly Christine Kerrigan.
Okay, yes. That's what I'm gonna focus on that part right there. CCC.
Yes.
Name a cowardly way to end a relationship.
Through a friend.
Through a friend.
Okay, good answer, Carly!
Megan, how you doing today?
I'm good, how are you?
Okay, good. Tell me a cowardly way to end a relationship.
To write a letter on
good
a piece
answer.
Of paper.
Write a letter.
How you doing, Steve?
Only guy in the family. Got your hands, tough. But the it's two tough. People down must keep you busy.
They do.
Okay, name a cowardly way to end a relationship.
I'm gonna say an email.
An email? Hey, Shannon.
Hey, Steve.
Turns out you're a pretty good player for your family.
That was yesterday. I hope I can hold it up today.
I know, you'll be all right, you'll be all right. Name a cowardly way to end a relationship.
Twitter. Tweet it.
That way everybody knows it's over.
Okay. It's over.
Tweet it. Okay, we got two strikes here, Kimberly. If it's there, you're still alive. If not, the Salisbury family gets a chance to steal.
Just never talk to him again.
Just don't ever talk to him again.
Ever again.
Don't even mention it. One answer left, Carly.
Come on, Carly.
Yeah, this is the family member that is all riding on right here. Here we go, Carly. Come on, you can do it now.
By just being with somebody else.
Good answer, Carly!
Go and be with someone else. Salisbury, here's your chance, Brian. For the steal, name a cowardly way to end a relationship.
Cheat.
To cheat. Number four. Stop calling.
Oh.
Hey, let's move on to question two. Give me Carly, give me Darius. Carly, get him, yeah.
Distract him.
Come
on, Darius.
What are you doing? Is that your wife over there? Oh, that's not your wife.
Yeah, I'm like you, she's at home.
Oh, that explains the gaze.
Uh-huh.
Okay, that's yours. Okay, okay, here we go. Top six answers are on the board. Are you serious, man?
You're looking right there.
No, you weren't. Yours is over here.
Oh, that's right.
That's hers. We ask 100 women, name something a man might do in the bathtub. Okay, Darius.
Sing.
We asked 100 women, name something a man might do in the bathtub that would make you think he's really immature.
Pass gas.
Passing gas.
We're gonna pass.
Okay. You got out there and lost your mind, didn't you? Just jumping on the bus all there. Okay, LaDon, tell me. We ask 100 women. Name something a man might do in the bathtub that would make you think he's really immature.
Pee.
Dwayne, how you doing?
Great, how about yourself?
What do you do, man?
Financial aid advisor at Morehouse College in Atlanta, Georgia. I'm also a professional drummer.
Wait a minute, well, stop right there. You're what at Morehouse?
Financial aid advisor.
Can I tell you something? My two sons, I just dropped them off at Morehouse College night before last.
I heard that. That's also my alma mater.
That's good. Well, look out for my sons over there. They didn't get the financial aid package. I was hoping for that, but they asked me to leave the meeting up. So we ask 100 women, name something a man might do in the bathtub that would make you think he's really immature.
Play with a rubber ducky.
Play with the rubber ducky. Uncle Bob. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great, Steve.
What do you do for a living, sir?
I'm a retired educator of 26 years. Pastor a church and operate a child developmental center.
You pastor a church, too?
Yes.
Oh, okay. All of that? Wow. Busy man. Well, thanks for coming, man. We ask 100 women name something a man might do in the bathtub that will make you think he's really immature, and the congregation's listening.
Play with himself.
That's a good one. That gotta be up there.
That's gotta be up there. You shut up. What are you talking about? Jumping on the buzzer all early and stuff. Sitting in the bathtub playing with yourself.
That's all right. That's okay.
Yep, you're gonna have quite a sermon to preach this Sunday, partner, I gotta tell you that.
Yeah. I'm gonna stay in Orlando.
You're gonna stay home this Sunday, yeah. Mr. Bryant, where are you folks from?
We're originally from Douglasville, Georgia. Yes, sir.
You are, sir?
I am a captain in the United States Army stationed at Hartsfield Jackson National Airport. I take care of the soldiers who are coming back from Iraq and Afghanistan. Get ready to go home and spend 2 weeks with their families here in the U.S.
All right, brother Lowe.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Appreciate everything y'all doing for
us
out
there,
too. We ask 100 women, Brian, name something a man might do in the bathtub that will make you think he's really immature.
Burp.
Burp in the bathtub. Burp. Darius, two strikes. If it's there, you're still alive. If not, the Kerrigan family get ready to steal.
Spit.
Good answer. Good answer.
In the bathtub. Kerrigan, here's your chance. Name something a man might do in the bathtub that will make you think he's really immature, Kimberly.
They're both really good, but we're gonna go with bubbles! Bubble bath!
Bubbles!
Bubbles! Come on, bubbles!
Bubbles! Kerrigan family 166. Salisbury's not on the board yet, but remember, the goal is 300 points, so don't go away. We'll be right back. Hey, welcome back to Family. Feud, everybody. Kerrigan's 166. Salisbury's not on the board, but it's still anybody's game. Give me Megan, give me LaDonna. Let's go. Ladies, point values are doubled here, so it's going to be worth a little bit more. We've got the top five answers on the board. Finish the phrase. Hot blank. Megan.
Hot potato.
Hot potato. LaDonna.
Hot cakes.
Hot cakes.
We're going to play.
We're going to play, LaDonna. Big Bill. How you doing, man?
I'm doing good.
Steve. What do you think it is? Finish the phrase. Hot what?
I'm gonna say hot dog.
Hot dog. Shannon, finish the phrase. Hot what?
Hot damn.
Oh, can I say damn? I can't say damn.
Hot damn.
Okay.
Been working on my cussing and then here you come. Finish your phrase. Hot what?
Hot mess!
Hot mess.
Mess. Come on.
Hot mess.
Hot mess.
I'm just going. Question is, finish the phrase. Hot blank.
The PH makes an F sound.
Okay. Yes. Thanks. I'm gonna say hot iron.
Good answer.
Hot
good
iron.
Answer.
Hot tub, hot tub, hot tub, hot tub.
Salisbury, I don't mean to put a lot of pressure on you, but you need to do something here. Here's your chance. Finish the phrase, hot what?
Tamale.
Hot tamale.
Hot tamale.
Hot tamale. Number two. Hot stuff. Number five. Hot pants. Well, we got a good one going. Harrigan's 166, Salisbury 50. Anybody's game, come back, find out who wins this thing right after this. Hey, welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. The Kerrigan family, 166, Salisbury got 50. Give me Bill, give me Dwayne, let's go. Fellas, point values have tripled here. Top four answers are on the board. Name something bears like to eat. Dwayne.
Honey.
Honey. Bears like to eat honey. Pass the point.
We're gonna play.
They're gonna play. We're tripling the points, Bob, so let's just get to it. Name something bears like to eat.
They like to eat leftovers out of picnic baskets.
Yeah. Leftovers out the picnic baskets. Uh-oh. I thought that was good. Brian, name something bears like to eat.
Salmon.
Salmon. Salmon. Darius, name something bears like to eat.
Berries.
Berries, yeah. Berries. LaDonna, only one strike, only one answer left. Name something bears like to eat.
People.
They
good answer, come on.
Let me see something.
It's up there.
If it's up there, this is for the win. People. A lot of fun. People are real nice. You guys are super nice. Thanks a lot, okay? Hey, Salisbury, give me two people to play Fast Money. Let's go. We got Brian. We got Bob. They're going for Fast Money right after this. Yeah, here we go. To the Feud, everybody. Salisbury family won the game, and now it's time to play. Hey, before we start, someone would like to wish you luck.
Hey, Salisbury family, this is Jalen and Jackie, and we're here to wish you good luck. And Bob and Brian, we want you to win that fast money.
And remember, you win 5 games, you win the brand new car right there. Okay, Brian, Bob is off stage. He can't see or hear any of your answers. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. Try to give me the most popular answer. If you can't think of something, just say pass. If we have enough time, I'll get back to it. And then if you and Bob together put together 200 points, sir, would you please tell everybody what's gonna happen?
We win $20,000!
I think you better have his money. You ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something you remember getting punished for doing in school.
Talking.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how strong is family life in America?
6.
Name something you'd see in a church.
Cross.
Name something you rub.
Your hands together.
Name something in your home that seems to be on all the time.
Television.
There goes, lineup, going on. I said to name something you remember getting punished for doing in school, you said? Talking, survey said. That's how you do it. On a scale of 1 to 10, how strong is family life in America, you said? 6, survey said. I said to name something you see in a church, you said? A cross, survey said. I said, name something you rub, you said? Your hands together, survey said. I like that answer. Then I said, name something in your home that seems to be on all the time, you said? TV, survey said. Oh! Come on out here, Bob. Let's clear the board. Bob, gotta tell you something. Got some good news for you. What relationship are you to Brian?
I'm his uncle.
Well, your nephew just put up 113 points. You need 87 points. So, Bob, I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate any of the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'll say try again, you give me another answer. It's gonna be a little tougher this time, so I'm gonna give you 25 seconds. Okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's remind everyone of Brian's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Bob, the clock is gonna start after I read the first question. Name something you remember getting punished for doing in school.
Throwing erasers.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how strong is family life in America?
About a 5.
Name something you see in a church.
People.
Name something you rub.
Your back.
Name something in your home that seems to be on all the time.
The television.
Try again.
The answer machine.
Come on, man, let's see. Stay right here, stay right here. Come on, Bob, let's see what we got here. I said to name something you remember getting punished for doing in school. You said, you're old. Throwing erasers. Survey said,
that's okay.
Talking was the number one answer. On a scale of 1 to 10, how strong is family life in America? You said, 5. Survey said, 5 was the number one answer.
Yes.
I said to name something you see in church. You said, people. You a pastor, that's what you need to see. Survey said, cross was the number one answer. I said, name something you rub. You said, the back. Survey said, legs and knees was the number one answer. Then I said, name something in your home that seems to be on all the time. You said, you are really old. The answering machine. You need 50 points, man. Survey said, number one answer was TV.
TV.
That was it. You get them again next time. Don't worry about it, man. $5 a point for a total of $750. But Salisbury's coming back to face another family on the Feud. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks.
To plan your next Orlando vacation, go to visitorlando.com.